Hey guys, so this is a tutorial on how to install a VPN on a Windows laptop. So first you need to extract the VPN file. Then you run the installer. After you run the installer, now you can close this and then you can head over to your browser and then type this link. So after you type this link, you can create your own account. You can put your nickname, you can put your email and another email here for verification, and then you put your two passwords and you're going to receive a verification code in your email. So after you receive the verification code, just click the link, and after you click the link, you can now head over to your account and then log in. After you log into your account, you first want to come into the wallet and then top up your account. So you can just put 12 here and then you can use Alipay or WeChat to pay. After that, you can top up your account. So after you top up your account, you get like a QR code to scan. Then you can scan using your Alipay. If you did WeChat, you scan using WeChat. And then now you can head over to purchase your subscription in the store. So you click the store and then you can select your plan here. I usually use the monthly plan. You can enable the auto renewal, and then as you can see in my account, I already have 12 yuan, so I just need to pay now. So when you pay, you head over to your dashboard, and what you can see here is you have 300 gig if your account is still new. Since I'm using this account, I have 161. We need these links that are under this pie chart. So you can click the clash config and then import all your servers into your VPN app. So once you allow it, you need to head to the profiles. If not imported, you can come here again and then you can copy the URL link and then head over to the app, paste it here, and then download it. If it's successful, it will be added on the profiles, and then now you can head over to general and just turn on this proxy setting. So you need to turn it on, and then as you can see here, now you have a bunch of servers to connect to. But before you click any of the servers, as you can see the numbers here, it's 0 and 0, which means there is no data exchange that is happening. So you need to head over down here and then right click, and then you need to turn on the global, and then you make sure this is on system proxy. So after that, you can now click any server you want to use. For example, maybe I want to use United States. If I just double click, you begin to see the numbers moving soon. Once I type maybe YouTube, head here, you begin to see the numbers start to move. So that means that your VPN is working, is up and running. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this kind of videos, be sure to subscribe, because I'm going to be dropping more. Thank you.